Over 6 million people in the United States are unemployed due to the pandemic, and many of them are worrying about what they should do about their bills, questioning whether they should pay their rent, their mortgage, car payments, student loans, and many other bills, despite the fact that they don't have any money coming in. And I'm going to give you some tips to help you navigate these uncertain times. I'm Shana of The Wealth Vibe, and I create videos to help you eliminate debt, grow your income, and build wealth. We are in the midst of a pandemic, and millions of people have lost their jobs and income to be able to pay their bills and necessities such as food and water. And as we live through this pandemic for the next few months, bills are going to start to pile on, and many people are wondering if their emergency fund can even cut it, and if they'll be able to pay their bills, and wondering what should they do. On this channel, I have talked a lot about emergency funds, and a lot of people are saying, just use your emergency fund. However, that's not realistic for a lot of people because they may have not been able to ever build up an emergency fund because they've been paying down debt, or they've never been able to get out of that paycheck to paycheck cycle. And there are some people who are just in the midst of an emergency when this pandemic started. So they've been depleting their emergency fund. And those people are wondering, what should they be doing about their bills? Because they have rent, mortgage, student loan payments, and all these bills that are becoming due, and they're wondering how they're going to live when they don't have the funds to pay for those bills. Now, the simple answer is, if you have the ability to pay your bills, please pay your bills, because the bills that you pay impact another family. That impacts their income and their ability to pay their bills. And that also impacts another family, because it is a domino effect. We are in this world together, and we are living interconnected lives where the money that you pay then affects someone else, and someone else, and someone else, and so forth. So if you have the ability to get through this pandemic, pay your bills if you are fortunate enough to do so. Don't look at this as an opportunity to squander away some cash, especially if you have a job and an emergency fund that you can live on throughout this pandemic. Now, if you find yourself unemployed, on the verge of losing your job, or you don't really have a large nest egg to live on, if you were to lose income, then I have some solutions for you that might work out in your favor. You've probably heard by now that the president has signed into law the CARES Act that has provided trillions of dollars to Americans to help provide relief during this pandemic. And I did a recent video about the stimulus checks that many Americans probably will be receiving within the next 2 weeks to help out. And you can check out that video here, and it provides more details about what that is. But there are two other ways that the bill has been able to help people during this pandemic. One of the ways that the new law has been able to provide some relief to Americans is through federally backed mortgages. So the key word here is a federally backed mortgage. If you have a mortgage that is a Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac mortgage or a VA loan mortgage, you can get some relief on your mortgage payments. So you can postpone your payments or go into forbearance, that means delaying your payments for up to 3 months. And that will allow you to get by during these times and be able to save up money, or, you know, stash away money, the money that you do have, either from the job that you might still have or any money in your emergency fund during these times, because you won't have to pay them to your mortgage company. So as I mentioned, the key word is federally backed. If you have a conventional mortgage, some of the mortgage companies are still providing this type of assistance. So you just have to call up your mortgage company to find out what they are doing. However, there is a major disclaimer here. So some of these mortgage companies are offering a forbearance, but they are doing this in one or three ways that I've seen. The first way is that after the 3 month period is up, they're asking for you to pay back all 3 months in full. So they will be asking you to provide all those payments as back payments immediately. And so that might be something that will be very difficult for you to do. The second way that I've seen mortgage companies handle this is that they say that they will tack the 3-month payment towards the end of your loan term. So let's say that your mortgage was supposed to be up in October. Instead, you will continue making payments until December because they've tacked on an additional 3 months to the loan term. The third way that I've seen that some mortgage companies are handling this situation is that they will renegotiate the terms of your mortgage either by increasing your APR, your interest rate, or they're going to renegotiate the term of your loan. So instead of if you had a 15-year mortgage, they might increase it to a 30-year mortgage or take a 30-year mortgage and turn it into a 40-year mortgage. Those are the three ways that I've seen how mortgage companies are dealing with this forbearance situation. So you really want to think about if you truly cannot afford your mortgage payments. Otherwise, you might be putting yourself into a financial bind because if they raise your interest rates or lengthen your payment terms, you might end up spending a lot more money on your home, or you might end up putting yourself into foreclosure if you cannot afford to pay all of your past due payments during the forbearance term. So you really want to consider if this is the route for you. And if you can pay your mortgage, just pay your mortgage because it will be less of a headache for you in the end. If you are a renter, you might be wondering what your options are. Unfortunately, the law does not provide any provisions for renters. But what you might have to do is get in contact with your landlord to see what options they can pass on to you. Communication is key. Talk with your landlord and let them know what your situation is, whether you've lost your job or your income has been slashed. You want to let them know so that they can work out something with you. Maybe they'll postpone your payments, or maybe they'll cut your payments by a certain percentage or work out a payment plan for you. But it's really important that you communicate with your landlord. And I know how this situation impacts people firsthand because my boyfriend, he himself is a landlord, and he has tenants who have reached out that have been financially compromised during this time because they've lost their job, and he's been able to work out situations with them. So just communicate with your landlord because hopefully they'll be empathetic and be able to work something out. But if you can pay, you want to make sure that you do pay your rent because this has a domino effect. Your landlord relies on your rent to pay the mortgage on their property. And if they are not in a situation where they can get a forbearance on their mortgage, or if they have to pay their mortgage and they're unable to do that themselves because maybe they too lost their job, then you might be in a situation where you ultimately have to move when this all is over because they might also find themselves in a foreclosure situation or, you know, defaulting on their loan. And you don't want that situation to happen, especially if you are able to pay your rent. The other type of debt relief that Americans have been able to receive through the new law that has been enacted is through student loans, federally backed student loans. So that happens in two different ways, through forbearance and through 0% interest accrual. So I'm gonna talk about forbearance first. So up until September 30th, 2020, those who have federal student loans do not need to make a payment on their student loans. And so that's really great news. And that includes all of the different types of repayment plans, including public service loan forgiveness. So the great thing is that if you are on the public service loan forgiveness track, this actually helps you out tremendously, because they're going to treat it as you are actually making payments. So you're really getting 6 free payments during this time that will contribute towards your 120 payment total. So in the end, you're going to end up paying a lot less towards your loans throughout the public service loan forgiveness program. This is really great news for those people on the program. But if you're not in the program, it's still great news because you don't have to pay your student loans if you can't afford it. The other way that they've been able to provide some relief to federal student loan borrowers is through a 0% interest rate that will end on September 30th, 2020. So during this time period, your student loan should not accrue any interest at all during this time period. Now, keep in mind with the two things that I just mentioned, it's going to take some time for these loan companies, your loan servicers like Great Lakes, Nelnet, Navient, and FedLoan to actually implement these processes, but they're going to be retroactive up until March 13th. So from March 13th to September 30th, 2020, you should not accrue any interest and you should not have to owe any payments at all. Now, if you go log on to your loan service provider and it still shows that you're accruing interest or that you owe a payment, don't worry about it because it's going to take effect retroactively. And most student loan providers are doing this automatically. For example, I have Great Lakes and they are going to be putting into these things into effect automatically. But you might want to check with your specific loan service provider to see what provisions they're making for their borrowers. Now, you might be wondering if you have private student loans, does this apply to you? Unfortunately, it does not. But you might want to check in with your loan provider to see if they can do anything to work with you during this time because they might be extending some types of grace periods for you during this time, but you want to make sure that you're listening to the fine print details because they might be trying to increase your interest rates or do other tactics to allow them to recoup money that they might be losing during this time. So all you need to do is call them and ask what they can do to help you. Here's my advice on how to stay afloat during this pandemic. So the first thing is that you want to know what your options are. So you want to get in contact with your loan provider, so that's your mortgage company and your student loan companies, to find out what your options are, especially if you have a federally backed loan, such as a mortgage or a student loan. You want to find out what the options are and how do you need to work with your particular loan provider if you want to take advantage of those options. Because things might change. You might have a job now, but you might find yourself to be unemployed, as many people week by week tend to become unemployed, or you might be in a situation where your income is drastically slashed, as some employers are actually cutting back the salaries of their employees. So you want to figure out what your options are just in case you need to take those options. Then, if you do need to take advantage of the options, you want to listen to the fine print details. You want to know what are the repercussions if you do decide to take forbearance options now, because it might cost you a whole lot of money later. And then you want to consider if it's right for you. Can you actually financially manage by pulling from your emergency fund if you have one? Or can you maybe work out payment terms with someone to help you during this time? But you want to figure out if this is the right decision for you, given all the circumstances. If you find yourself in a really tough financial situation, then you want to take advantage of these opportunities because it will allow you to stash away money and preserve some money for some of the essential things that you need, such as food and shelter and water and even maybe even medical services. So you want to make sure that you take care of those things as priority. And by taking advantage of these opportunities through mortgage and student loan forbearance, that might be able to help you. This pandemic has caused a lot of people to reevaluate their finances because we've realized how fragile our economy is. It's really dependent on people being healthy and working and the interconnectedness of us all. And so people are now realizing that it's super important to have your financial affairs in order and have an emergency fund so that you can be prepared when the next emergency happens, whether that be a pandemic, a job loss, a death in the family, or anything else that could potentially happen. You might be wondering, what can you do to learn more so that when this happens again, you can be in the best financial situation? So you'll want to check out this video right here so that you can learn how to build your emergency fund so that when this happens next time, you are in a the best financial position possible. I appreciate you for watching, and I hope that you're subscribed so I can see you in the next video.